Back to again our online class. So in last class we have completed the first chapter, that is crop production and management, as well as we have solved exercise question. So dear students, now again we are going to enter next concept, that is biology concept. Okay, so as I told, biology means where we are learning the living things. Okay, we are learning about the living things. This is considered to be a biology part. So dear students, our next concept or next chapter is microorganism. So here the concept is depending upon the friend and foe. So what do you mean by these two words? What do you mean by this friend and foe words? So friend means the friends who help us in our bad situation or a good situation, which support us, so they are the friends and always thinks about good for us. But what do you mean by the foe word? Foe means enemy, which behaves like a enemy for us. So why we have given both the name for the microorganism? We have to discuss this thing itself in this microorganism chapter. So dear students, why we are calling about this microorganism? This is splitted as a two words, that is micro and the organism. What do you mean by the organism? So microorganism means you, me, living organism, as well as animals, this also a organism itself. Then what do you mean by the microorganism? So dear students, take a simple example. In your home itself, just look at around yourself. What are the things you can see? You can see bench, table, chair, cot. So these things you can see. But if a small needle will be there, or any small pieces of paper or anything, nail, so whether it is a possible to get in a suddenly? No. Why? Because it is very small size. Okay, it have a very small size. So here, why we am connecting this thing to this thing? Okay, so you can see the organism which are large in size. Okay, so just take a example about cow, buffalo. So easily you can see them. Okay, cat, dog, you can easily say you can see to them. But what about small animals? Okay, let's take a example of ants. Okay, is it possible to see them in a very easy manner? No, sometimes you can find, sometimes you cannot find, because they have a small size. Okay, usually the things which are having the 1 centimeter, okay, the measurement is around 1 centimeter, then you can see easily. But what happens if the size of the organism, it will going to be decreases less than 1 centimeter? Suppose 0.1 centimeter, if you are taking the example about 0.1 centimeter of the organism size, whether it is a possible to see them? No, it is highly impossible, because we cannot see by our naked eyes. So here the microorganisms are the organism which cannot see by our naked eyes. Naked eyes means our open eyes, normal eyes, we cannot see those organism. Okay, so the size is about 0.01 centimeter or 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer. The size is very it can be variant. Okay, so we cannot see by our naked eyes. How much small it is, just think about these things. So whether it is a possible to see? Yes, it is possible to see them. But how it is a possible to see those microorganism? By the help of the microscope. Okay, by the help of the microscope. So dear students, let's take a simple example. You can see my hand. Okay, so I can see some dust particles are there on my hand, but I will say no, I have washed my hands, so my hands are clean. But also some of the microorganisms are existing here. Yes, some of the microorganisms are existing here on our body itself. Suppose I am going to outside, and after coming back from outside, if I am not going to wash my hand, some of the microorganisms are with me. Okay, at that situation what happens? I can become a ill. Okay, this is one of the criteria that microorganism is behaves like a foe in nature, enemy in nature. So that's why we are becoming ill. Why we are becoming ill? For example, by taking the example of such things. Okay, so you can take another examples about the tiles at your home. Okay, so some of the microorganisms are existing on the tiles itself. You can take a simple example about the toilets. So that's why always we are saying no, clean the toilet, clean the tiles. Why? Because microorganisms are existing there in the dust particles they are, and in the soil the microorganisms are there. So these are the criteria, these are the place where microorganism existing. So in this case what happened? The microorganism behaves as a foe. Yes, behaves as a foe in nature, enemies to us. But what about this concept that friend? Okay, so what is your favorite breakfast? Just recall it. Okay, my favorite breakfast is idli and dosa. But how you are preparing this idli and dosa batter? Okay, so you are preparing this idli dosa means before one day itself you are preparing the batter of idli and dosa. Okay, then what happened next day? You can see there some bubbles, and you can see there the batter of dosa become a swelling in nature. Is it? So how it happens? Due to the presence of microorganism. So that's why we are eating. Okay, but what we feel? Yeah, it is very delicious. Yes, it is very delicious. So in this situation, is it harm for us? No. They gives us a very good taste to our tongue. So what happens in this situation? The microorganism is behaves like a friend. Okay, so you are having the curd. Okay, how the forming of curd is possible? From the milk itself. So how it is possible? After the keeping for 10 to 12 hours, the milk it is going to be converted into curd, and curd is very good for health. So in this situation, microorganism is behaves like a friend. Is it? So these are the microorganism concept that we have to be learn in this chapter. Okay, so dear students, let's take some few points about the microorganism. Okay, so the size of the microorganism is less than 0.1 nanometer. Okay, it is highly impossible to see by our naked eyes. We cannot see by our naked eyes. Okay, so we cannot see by our naked eyes. The third point about the microorganism, that we can see the microorganism with the help of microscope. Okay, we can see the microorganism with the help of microscope. Okay, with the help of microscope. And The scientists who are studying about the microorganism, they usually known as microbiologist. Okay, so it is a another point. The scientist who studying the studying about microorganism about microorganism is known as microbiologist. Okay, so before taking this point, another point you can add here, the study of microorganism is known as a microbiology. Okay, so the study of microorganism is known as microbiology. Okay, so these are the some key points related to the microorganism, that the size is less than 0.1 nanometer, we cannot see by our naked eyes, we can see the microorganism with the help of microscope. The scientist who studying about microorganism is known as microbiologist, and the study of the microorganism is known as microbiology. Okay, so here some few points I have discussed with you. So whether they have classified, yes, the microbiologist, what they have done, they have classified the microorganism totally 5 categories. Okay, let's discuss those 5 categories. Okay, so microorganism classified into classified into usually 4 categories. Okay, usually into 4 categories, that is bacteria, algae, fungi, protozoa, and one additional part, that is virus. Additional part as virus. So these are the classification of microorganism. That is, first one is the bacteria, second one is the algae, third one is the fungi, fourth one is the protozoa, and the additional part as a virus. So here these are the some introduction part of the microorganism. In next class we will going to study one by one these things, as well as I will explain how to draw this microorganism, which will be very important for examination purpose. So dear students, just take down these points and complete all the things that what we have discussed in today's class. So in next class we will start with studies of one by one. Okay, dear students. So let's meet in the next class. Have a good day. Bye bye.